So this year, in 2022, we're going to be getting a whole load of new MacBooks coming from Apple. And today I want to talk about these brand new MacBooks that we're expecting. There's a whisper that we could be getting a larger MacBook Air coming out in 2022. And also we're going to see the debut of that M2 chipset, what is likely to be going inside the MacBook Air as well. So let's discuss about every single new MacBook we're expecting to see in 2022. Hi, it's Matt here. So that's right, in 2022, we're expecting a whole load of new MacBooks to come out. Now, first of all, I do want to point out that straight away that most of these MacBooks that we're going to be seeing are probably not going to be coming out at this end of 2022. So when we have the spring events that's coming up very soon in March or April time, it's unlikely we're going to be seeing any new MacBooks. And the main reason behind this is that there's still that rollout of the M1 Pro and the M1 Max chipsets in lots of other kind of Mac devices, like the new Mac Mini of the higher spec, and also the anticipated iMac Pro with that larger 27-inch display, or even possibly a 30 or 32-inch display that is coming around March or April time. Also at WWDC later on this year, it is most likely we're going to be seeing kind of the launch of the new Mac Pro, and this is the big tower that Apple do, but probably the actual Mac Pro will not get released at that time. It will probably come out later on in the year. But then that leaves to all the events that will be happening later on in the year around about fall time, and that's kind of around about October, November time. And normally, like we've seen in previous years, Apple love to do kind of a Mac event around that time. In 2020, we got the introduction of the M1 chipset, and that was inside the MacBook Air, the MacBook Pro 13-inch, and also the Mac Mini. And then last year, in October time, we got the brand new 14-inch MacBook Pro, and also that 16-inch MacBook Pro, with that talked about M1 Pro and M1 Max chipset inside. So basically, the cards are on that the new M2 chipset is going to be coming out around the end of 2022, and it's going to be in a couple of new MacBooks. So let's first of all talk about the M2 chipset and what we're expecting from it. Well, to be deadly honest, it's not going to be that much different in CPU kind of architecture compared to the M1. We're expecting kind of an 8-core setup again in the CPU element, and this will again be 4 efficiency cores and 4 performance cores, just like what we have right now with the M1. But the GPU is where things are going to shape up a little bit. There's been leaks and there's been reports out there that instead of having an 8-core GPU, that this time we'll in fact get a 10-core GPU. So 2 extra cores inside the M2 chipset will give the M2 far more better kind of performance in its graphical element, which is going to be absolutely amazing. Overall though, what I would say is that the M2 chipset probably still will not be as powerful as the likes of say an M1 Pro or an M1 Max, but it will be catching up, and it will basically bridge that gap between the M1 and the M1 Pro. And even that M1 Pro, what's the bin version, so this is the one that gives you 8 cores, so that's 2 efficiency cores and 4 performance cores, it is most likely that the M2 chipset will still be a little bit less powerful than that actual M1 Pro sort of chipset that we got out at the end of 2021. But that M2 chipset, of course, will be more efficient, still will be more powerful, like I just mentioned, than the current M1 that we have right now, and will still be a fantastic chip to definitely get your hands on in the new MacBooks that are coming out with it. So that M2 chipset is probably going to be going in all the MacBooks that I'm going to be talking about in this video. It's unlikely that we're going to see an M1 Pro or an M1 Max put inside any other type of MacBook between now and the end of 2022. So that M2 chipset is most likely, first of all, going to go inside the likes of the new MacBook Air. If you've been watching my videos on my channel for a while now, you probably have actually seen that I've been talking about this MacBook Air quite a fair bit. And a lot of other people out there have as well. We've been told that the biggest change, what you can see here in some of these renders, is that there's going to be colors added to the MacBook Air. And this is very in line with what we have with, say, with that kind of 24.5-inch iMac that we got in 2021. That kind of color range, Apple going back to its roots with the original kind of iMac back in the day, it's going to be going to those kind of colors, and that is what we're going to be getting inside the MacBook Air, because it's kind of that kind of standard kind of machine that can just do every kind of daily task at it. It can even do video video editing, photo editing, and all those things really, really well. And the M1 chipset has proven that it can do that. Obviously, the M1 Pro and the M1 Max is for real hardcore professionals, but you can definitely be able to do some editing of some videos that you've done on your iPhone or even on some sort of light vlog sort of cameras out there. It is going to be still a great MacBook. We've been told, though, with this MacBook Air, again, just like with the current one, there'll be no fan inside it, so it will just be running off the actual sort of CPU and GPU, so it'll be completely fanless, which is going to be absolutely awesome. And also, the design is going to change ever so slightly in bits and pieces, so we're going to be getting the likes of, say, MagSafe being added, and we'll probably get probably about two USB-C ports added as well. There's kind of words out there that we might get an SD card slot added or HDMI, but it doesn't look likely. This is what this MacBook Air is kind of for. It would be cool if it did have it, but from what we're hearing, it probably isn't going to get these ports. Just probably the USB-C ports, those Thunderbolt 4 ports, and also a MagSafe charger as well, what makes complete sense. For the actual screen, we've been told we're probably going to be possibly getting another Retina display, but what we haven't been told if it's going to be a mini LED display or not, like we have with the current MacBook Pros that came out the end of 2021. We don't know if it's going to be a ProMotion display, and also something else that has been talked about, we don't know if it's going to have a notch inside the screen or not, or if we're going to have borders around it. It's possible, it's a 50-50 I'd say right now, if we're going to have a notch or not, but personally, you know, I've got a MacBook Pro with a notch inside it, and it hasn't really been bothering me that much, and to be fair, I know a lot of other people out there hasn't really been bothering them that much, so if they did introduce a notch to the MacBook Air, I don't think really many people would care. But one thing though that you should care about, and that is definitely the giveaway that we're doing on this channel right now, and it's for this. It is for an iPhone 13 Pro Max, and it's in this silver white color that you can see here, and it's a 256 gigabyte model. And I'm going to be giving away this MacBook Pro, not this MacBook Pro, this iPhone 13 Pro Max to one lucky subscriber when we get over 350,000 subscribers, and it's not that far away. And all I want to know from you guys to write down in the comments below to be in a chance for getting your hands on this international giveaway is what Apple gear or what technology gear are you planning to buy in 2022? Write it down in the comments below. And if you're new here, make sure you subscribe to this channel and also hit that notification bell, because you'll want to get that notification of when I create that video of announcing who the winner is for this iPhone 13 Pro Max when we get over 350,000 subscribers. Now, one thing I just quickly want to mention on that, there's a lot of kind of spammers and scammers out there who are saying, "What's that mean? You've won a prize. Oh, you are big winner," whatever. It's not me. They're all scammers, they're all spammers. You've heard it from me in this video. I will be announcing the winner via a video only. You will not be getting a message from me like that to say WhatsApp me, because that is not me. They are spammers and they are spammers, so do not listen to them whatsoever. But anyway, let's move on then with the next MacBook that's going to be coming out in 2022. So right now, if you look up the lineup of the MacBook Pros, we currently have the 16-inch MacBook Pro, we have the 14-inch MacBook Pro, and we also still have the 13-inch MacBook Pro with that M1 chipset inside it. And a lot of you are wondering, well, what's going to happen to this MacBook Pro? It's got the older design with that touch bar and everything. What's going to happen? Well, there has been leaks and reports out there to say that this MacBook Pro design is going to be completely scrapped. And what we're going to be getting instead is the current 14-inch MacBook Pro shell design, but instead of an M1 Pro and M1 Max inside it, we will actually get a M2 chipset inside. Now, to me, I'm a little bit puzzled by this move if this does actually happen, because like I said, that M2 chipset is going to be a little bit more powerful than the M1, but not as powerful as, say, the M1 Pro, the bin version, but it's going to be in between. But to me, in my opinion, to get that inside the same sort of design, the same sort of screen shell and everything that we have right now with the current 14-inch MacBook Pro, it doesn't really make much sense to do that. And personally, in my opinion, if it's going to be like $100 or $200 between the pricing of the M2 to the M1 Pro, personally, I would pick the M1 Pro over the M2. But then having said that, you know, I would actually kind of thinking about it now, possibly pick the M2, because it probably might get an extra year of operating system updates. It's confusing. And that's why the whole thing about this, that people are saying they're going to use that design for the M2 chipset, is really, really confusing. Personally, what I think they should do is maybe make a 14-inch MacBook Pro based on the design that we currently have right now for the M1 Pro and M1 Max 14-inch, but maybe take away a USB port, maybe not have a ProMotion display inside it. Yes, I know what you're thinking, you would love to have these features still, but you can see what I mean. It doesn't really make sense to either pick the M2 or the M1 Pro MacBook Pro 14-inch. It's going to be really hard to decide which one to pick, and Apple don't really like to do that. They like to distinguish their products, that you pick this one, you get these features. If you pick this one, you get these features. But really, overall, you'll probably be getting very similar features. So yeah, very, very confusing. But like I said, there has been leaks and reports out there that there will be a new 14-inch MacBook Pro. And what that will look like, we'll have to wait and see. Make sure though, guys, that you subscribe to this channel, and like I said, hit that notification bell, because I'll be making videos when we hear more information about this MacBook Pro. The last MacBook that I want to talk about, and this one has been a bit of a whisper in the air, to be honest. And to be honest, I think it would sell like hot pancakes. And that is a larger MacBook Air. Based on sort of the design that we probably got in the past of like the 16-inch Intel MacBook Pro. So this was the last generation 16-inch MacBook Pro, and this is one that had like the USB-C ports on the sides and things like this. It had no MagSafe or anything, but maybe it could be adapted to have MagSafe. A lot of you people have been crying out there to say that one of the things that they love about a MacBook is actually having a larger display. And at the end of the day, you got to see like the iPhones right now. The iPhones, or one of the iPhones, I think it's the second top most selling iPhone out there, is the 13 Pro Max. And you know, it's very, very close behind the standard iPhone 13. So there's a lot of people who actually do really, really want larger Apple display devices. So I think Apple, if they did create this sort of 16-inch or 15.2-inch MacBook Pro, MacBook Air, I should say, see, it's still stuck in my head, Pro, then I think it would sell really, really well with an M2 chipset inside it. But we'll have to wait and see. And if they did create this, it is most likely it would be called the MacBook Air Max. Well guys, those are all the kind of MacBooks that are going to be coming up in 2022. We're definitely going to be getting a new MacBook Air design, and also a new MacBook Pro smaller one, or kind of lower powered device. But there's, like I said, there's only whispers around that we will be getting a larger MacBook Air. What are your thoughts, guys? Would you love to see these new MacBooks? Let me know in the comments below. Also at the same time, guys, if you've enjoyed watching this video, please make sure you press the like button as well. Well, it's time to wrap it up. So like I said, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews and comparisons, please make sure you subscribe to the channel and also hit that notification bell. Until next time, guys, I will see you really soon. Bye bye.